Is God calling you to give up dating for a season of time? Is fasting from Christian dating and even thinking about relationships something healthy that Christians should do sometimes? In this video, I'm going to give you one reason that you shouldn't fast from Christian dating and three reasons that you should fast from Christian dating. So hopefully these 4 points can kind of help you gauge whether or not this is something that God's calling you to do or not do in this season of your life. Hey everyone, my name's Mark and this is ApplyGodsWord.com. If you haven't joined this community on YouTube by tapping that subscribe button, I would love for you to join us by doing so. We're posting new videos every single week, a lot about Christian singleness and dating, and I really try to really hone in on that season of life in singleness. Maybe down the line, my channel will expand into some other niche areas, but right now, I like to really focus on singles and just general biblical truth and try to apply that to that season of life. So if that's you, tap that subscribe button. So in this video, the first thing we should do is talk about what fasting is according to Scripture. Fasting is a period of time that has a specific time frames around it where someone gives up something so that they can more intentionally focus on God. Usually that person is giving up food or sometimes water and liquids, but usually a fast is associated with food. And again, it's a point where someone puts food to the side and says, I'm going to focus on God in a more direct way. It's really a outward sign of an inward hunger for God. It's really a time in Scripture where people use it to say, my ultimate satisfaction and my ultimate need is not in earthly things, but in God Himself. Also in Scripture, fasting is usually associated with prayer. Fasting and prayer usually go hand in hand, and it's an intensified season of prayer where you're praying instead of eating, or you're praying instead of, you know, this thing that you gave up in your fast. Another thing about fasting in the Bible is that it's often used as a season of intensely asking God for an answer about a specific thing in life. So in Acts 14, for example, the church fasted so that they could make sure that they were choosing the right men for elders in the church. And so they had a decision to make, and fasting was something that they did to really seek God for that answer. So the first reason I don't think that Christians should fast from dating and from even maybe thinking about dating or being open to the relationship in their heart, where they're saying, hey, no matter what happens, I'm going to not date. I'm not going to think about dating in this season of life. One reason I don't think you should do that is if you're trying to barrage God with prayer requests and fasting to gain favor so that God will bless you with a marriage. Fasting is not meant to be like a hunger strike where you're storing up spiritual points in heaven and suffering for Jesus, and then God will more likely bless you with what you want. That type of mentality is really based in a works theology. I've heard some unbiblical teachers talk about fasting like the spiritual H-bomb, and that if you suffer for Jesus, you know, he's going to explode blessings on you because you're fasting. That's nonsense. That's unbiblical. That takes fasting completely out of context and makes God's blessings based on your works. That, like, you're saying, I'm suffering, therefore I deserve God to bless me with X. And that's super unbiblical. All blessings ultimately flow to us through the grace of Jesus Christ, not because we are suffering and gaining points in heaven. So fasting has many benefits, but using fasting as a season in life to bang on the doors that God has clearly shut is not something that you should use fasting for. So the first good reason that I do believe fasting from relationships and fasting from the thoughts of relationships would be helpful to you is if you know you are idolizing relationships. So I don't mean that you should use fasting as a way of getting God to forgive you. God's going to forgive you if you confess your sins. If you idolize relationships and you know it's gotten too elevated in your heart and your mind, you ask God to forgive you, you repent, you turn the other direction, it's done right away. So I'm not saying if you've done that, you must fast. I'm not saying that everyone who's idolized relationships should stop dating and focus on singleness right now. Sometimes you just need to repent, choose the right motives, and keep pursuing, you know, a Christian spouse in that way. However, fasting can be helpful. It can be a way to overcome that idolatry because, again, it can be a season where you're realigning your desires and you're saying, you know what, I need to let that go for a while so that I can refocus my attention on God and refocus my devotion on Him. The second reason that it might be good for you to go on a season of fasting from dating and from thinking about relationships is if you just got out of a relationship and a lot of sin occurred in that relationship. So again, like I just said, I'm not saying that so that God will forgive you, so that, you know, you did something, therefore you need to suffer, so God will, you know, wipe away your debt. No, that's what Jesus Christ did on the cross. However, as a form of repentance, meaning turning the other direction, it might be needed to take some time aside and kind of analyze what went wrong in that relationship. Why did I sin sexually? Why did I sin verbally? Why did I sin emotionally? What occurred in that relationship? And when you instantly jump into a new relationship and you're instantly thinking about the next relationship in your heart and your mind, sometimes it can be very difficult to figure out what went wrong and to actually repent of what happened. So it's a good way to repent if you know you've sinned just recently. You don't want to repeat the same mistakes again, the same sins again in a new relationship. So fasting can really help if that is something you're coming out of. So the third reason that we'll talk about in this video where you might really want to fast is that fasting can make your prayers more powerful. But let me explain why, because it's not, again, because you're suffering for God and He thinks, wow, you know, you're doing such a great job, I'm going to boost your prayers with some, you know, extra points because of the hard work you're doing. That's not why fasting improves your prayers. Ultimately, powerful prayers are prayers that are in alignment with God's will. If you pray for something that isn't God's will for your life, God isn't going to answer that prayer. So with that said, the best way to have powerful prayers is to pray in alignment with the will that God already has for you. So prayer really isn't about, you know, telling God what to do and He's just jumping through all the hoops we're telling Him to jump through in heaven and all of that. Prayer is ultimately more about us being sanctified and conformed to the will that God already has for us through our prayers. And when you fast, again, you're going through an intense season of focusing on God. And when you do that, your sensitivity to the Spirit's leading will be enhanced, thus allowing you to pray prayers that are more in alignment with the will of God. And so when you fast from relationships, then you come back into a season where you're ready to start dating or you're ready to start thinking about relationships more, your prayers and your sensitivity to the Holy Spirit will be far greater. Here's what it says in 1 John chapter 5, verses 14 through 15. It says, "And this is the confidence that we have towards Him, that if we ask anything according to His will, He hears us. And if we know that He hears us in whatever we ask, we know that we have the request that we have asked of Him." So again, that just, you know, that's support for what I just said, that if you pray in alignment with the will of God, God's going to answer that prayer. So in summary, fasting can be so helpful because it can sanctify your desire for marriage. Your desire for marriage is not bad. Marriage is something good that God has designed, but that desire for marriage can move into a bad place, and you don't need to give up your desire for marriage if you're sinning in that way. What you really need is that desire to be sanctified. You need to cleanse that desire and put it in its rightful place so that God can bless you in a healthy way rather than with an idol or some sort of desire that's gone too far. And again, a season of fasting from Christian dating can really help you in that process. Well, I'm Mark from ApplyGodsWord.com. If this was a video that you found helpful, give it a thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe to this channel so that every time we post a new video, you don't miss out. Thanks so much for watching and God bless.